It's 8:10 with Kevin and Taylor in the morning. It's going to be sunny today and a high reaching about 68, which is going to be really great news because you and I, Taylor, are going out to the Family Christian Store later this afternoon, about 11:30, for the Amy Grant meet and greet and signing and stuff.
You can meet her from 11:30 to 1 today. Anybody can come.
Great weather. We're going to say hi to people out in line.
Hey there, I'm Dan Ratcliffe from Afternoons on 104.7 The Fish, and we are starting a live broadcast on the web, and so let me say hi to everybody who's listening on the web right now on the Fishbowl. Everybody say hi to everybody who's watching on the web. Say hi.
Hello. Hi.
There's the official webcam. Just kind of an intimate gathering with Amy Grant. Please welcome Amy Grant.
But it felt like if somebody had said, okay, we need to make soup right now, and I opened my refrigerator and went, have I got some? This is going to be a blast. I'm sorry, the only song I didn't write was better than Hallelujah. And so October has rolled around and of 2009, and my friend Ruth had passed away on October 6th, and this was less than 2 weeks later. And my mom and dad, in October, we moved them to assisted living. My mom has round-the-clock care. And then other things that had happened, I'm in my PJs with a cup of coffee, and I'm sent an email, and I open it up, and I hear the song, Better Than Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I hit play. God loves a lullaby.
I put my kids to sleep to your records. Works every time.
What about
El Shaddai?
You drove here, so which one here? El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Elohim Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same. By the power of the name El Shaddai, El Shaddai,
I grew up listening to Amy Grant, singing her music in church, being encouraged by her music in college, and
all I know how to say is that El Shaddai touches me in a very deep place, in a very deep way, and every time I hear it, I cry.
Her music has just tracked with my faith, and all along the way to now being a mom of three boys, she is still making me challenged in my faith.
I've been listening to her stuff since she first came on the scene back in the mid-70s, and she's done nothing but get better. Just gets better and better.
Thank the Fish so much for organizing this, and I'm so thankful I won. Her music is really, really great, and I especially like the lyrics. When I listen to the lyrics.
And I grew up with Amy Grant. She was just amazing to me. I actually did a gymnastics floor routine to El Shaddai because it meant so much to me.
And I think she sings a lot of her songs from her personal experience. And like I said, she's got a gift from the Lord, and I enjoyed her music.
Amy Grant has had an incredible impact on me. I'm sure she probably gets tired of hearing all these stories from people, but for me, she's one of the reasons why I got in Christian music radio in the first place.
Loved Amy, loved her since I was a little girl. In fact, when I was growing up, I always told people I was going to sing backup for her. That never happened. Oh well, still loved her.
Hi, thanks for joining us.
Bye, everybody.
Thanks for joining us in the Fishbowl.
Okay, glad that pressure to be perfect.
obviously I get somebody else to play the guitar on the records. But you don't have to be a great musician to write songs.
Amen, that's good.
To be honest.
That's right.
Telling all that I come from, all that I live for, and all that I'm going to be. My precious Savior is more than ever to me. My precious Jesus is more than ever to me.
Get your feet back on the ground.